How may I assist you?
Yearning to play a few rounds of Gwent.
I assist you.
So long.
How can I help you?
Up for a few rounds of Gwent?
It's drizzling.
Thank you. Oh.
Fancy a gander at our little stockpile? We've gathered ourselves quite the collection. Why let such nice things waste away in peasant halls?
Wouldn't mind a few rounds of Gwent.
Now you behave.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Ever play Gwent?
I do. And what's more, I usually win. If you've a deck, sit down. Outplay me, and I'll give you one of my unique cards. How's that for enticement?
Let's lay him down. Thank you.
man's only as good as his word. Take the card. I fear Velen's short on worthy opponents. Boatbuilder in Oriton might be one. There was also an old soothsayer. Lived east of here, near the windmill last I heard. There's a lad, about as reasonable as an old mare, but he plays a devilish hand. In fact, I don't rightly know that you're ready for him.
What do you want?
Want to talk to the Pellar?
Too late. We've got dibs on a chat with him. A long one.
What do you want from him?
To give him what he deserves.
And that is?
He done conjured auguries. Said something evil had made its nest in Edric's bowels. Told Edric to eat rowan berries. Lots of them.
Ever since Edric's lived in the outhouse. And he's got hardened pustules all over him.
Just so happens I need the Pellar alive. So if you agree to leave him alone, for good, I'm willing to tell you how to help Edric.
Well, all in all...
Yes or no?
Fine. Let's hear it.
A tea of mullein leaves for his belly, and cover his boils with mallow. A few days and he'll be good as new.
Noted. But if it don't work, we'll be back. Move out, boys. Prick.
Gotta wonder about a man who could get Edric's friends all worked up.
My old lady, got a knack for herbs. The other shot, Mallow, ought to have that too. Chopped it, and it's our hooker's feet.
Hey, anybody home? Open up, it's safe now.
Devils. Who do they bring? What seek ye?
I need your help.
Whoa, a man, nay, a wolf, grey, though not old. 'Tis he the Pellar awaits.
You were expecting me.
Aye, as the bones declared I should. They shall come whose stench is rape and death, but the wolf shall disperse them, the white wolf. And thus he comes. Omens never lie.
Recognize this? Made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna, to protect her.
You make the amulet?
Aye, sure 'twas the Pellar. After the way of his forefathers, over still water in the light of a full moon. Proper as amulets go. It protected well. Should never have taken it off.
So, designed to protect her, from what?
Oh, the dear. Besieged she was, evil all around, wanting to possess her. Old magic, born of oblivion, from dark sources emerged.
Old magic? Can you be more specific?
'Tis not for mouth speech, nor for the touch. A small protective charm, not a thing more a Pellar could do.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay, no, nay. Pellar don't know. But the spirits could know. The Pellar will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits? Great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost. Must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess! My goat! She's fled!
Those men must have scared her off. Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat? Impossible. No goat? Won't work.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
Princess! Princess! Where have you got to, girl?
Fine. I'll get your goat.
The bell. The little bell's ringing. She loves it. Ring, ring, and she will follow. But for a while. But beware of wild strawberries. Raspberries, too.
Yeah, treacherous as beasts go. I always keep an eye out for them. This way, I think. Another clue. Good. Another clue. Good. Damn it. Here, goat. Here, princess. Hoofed and horned. Should have known it would be stubborn. Come on, let's go see the Pellar. Come on, damn it. Should have guessed as much. What's a witcher compared to a patch of wild strawberries? Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? This way, Your Grace.
Bear! Bear! Run, you stupid piece of shit!
Where the hell'd you go? Do I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow? Storm, damn it. You're no roach, but I bet we could be friends in time. You've got that all-important quality every roach has to have. You don't talk much.
Princess, flee not from the Pellar, for there are wolves about.
Goat of mine, dearest, sweetest goat.
Happy for you, but I'm kinda in a hurry. Anna and Tamara, they might be in danger.
The White Wolf helped the Pellar, and so the Pellar shall help him.
Blood. We need blood. A living being.
Fine. Be right back. Will this do?
Child that lives not, yet did not die.
It's over? Is that it?
That is it.
Spirits had nothing more to say? Like where they went or where they are now?
You came for an augury, and augur I did. They're gone, the child remains.
Mentioned a child. Whose?
Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was, and she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
Anna tell you all this? Did she come here after it happened?
Nay, not Anna. 'Twas the omens told me.
Great, so I can be sure it's true.
The omens need not your faith to be true. It is you who needs the omens to lead you to truth.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is, and he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you, you must have noticed something.
The Pellar's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown, without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders, it seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
'Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
Why do you want its blood?
Blood. Blood, blood. It binds men for all ages, the living and the dead.
Sure, but what do you want to do with it?
At times, a century is too short for two brothers to reconcile. One dies before things are set right. The other then brings his blood to the Pellar.
And what does the Pellar do?
He awaits Forefather's Eve. He mixes the blood with milk, herbs, and hen's feet. He drinks to reconcile the dead with the living. There shall be no Forefather's Eve this year. But we'll find a way, all the same.
I hear you right. You mentioned Forefather's Eve. Pretty old custom. Thought it had died out.
Death lurks in every bog and puddle round here. Folk know they could die. Their earthly matters unresolved. Then they require help, or they'll not know peace. Forefather's Eve must be performed. Light the tallow candles to lead them through the dark. Call them by name. Appease their regrets. Only then may they depart in peace.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight, near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.